Choi Young Wook has asked us how to assemble metal citadel miniatures. Now, doing this is very simple, but you need to get hold of some tools before you begin. First of all, you'll need a set of clippers like I've got here, and you'll also need some files and some super glue as well to put your miniature together. Now, the miniature I've got for the example for this is a Talon Desert Raider Sergeant, who you can see I've got here. And the first thing that you should look for is any bits of flash on the miniature. And these stand out quite clearly. What I mean is these little bits of metal that are sticking out, such as this one underneath the base here like this. Now, removing these is really simple. All you've got to do is get your clippers, put the flat of the blade up next to the part like that, and just snip them away. Really simple like that. So all you've got to do now is go around your miniature looking for these, but do be careful as you're doing it, because some of them can be hidden quite cleverly, really. And also, some of them can look like detail, so just double check before you snip anything off. Once you've removed all those bits of flash, you're ready to move on to the next step, which is to look for any mould lines. Now, generally, the mould lines will run all the way around the outside of the miniature. And in fact, if we look very closely at the plasma pistol, you can see one that's just running down the top of the barrel of the gun just down there. It carries on up the coils, it goes over the shoulder, and over the top of the head, it goes along just there and down there. Now, I know it's very faint on this model. Sometimes it will stand out a little bit more, but it's important that you get rid of it regardless, because it will show up during painting. To remove it, all you need to do is just use your filer, and all you do is just very lightly just file it away like that, and there we go, the line's removed. Now, as you are filing away, you'll notice that the metal becomes very shiny, but don't worry about that. So long as it feels smooth, you won't notice it when you're painting it. I've finished filing away the mould lines now, and you can see the shinier metal where the metal has been removed, but it is smooth, so that's good, because once we start painting it, you won't be able to see any of that. Now, the next step is to check for any parts that are bent, because the metal does have some flex in it. In this case, we need to look at the sword. Now, the sword's supposed to be curved, but it's actually curved a bit too much. And also, if I look at it like that, you can see the blade isn't in line with the hilt either. So what we need to do is just bend that back into place. All you do is just apply some gentle pressure to it, and you'll see it just starts bending back to where we want it to be. And it will stay where it is. And also, we just need to bend this a little bit as well. And there we go. Now, something worth bearing in mind with this is the more times you flex it, the weaker it will get and the closer it gets to snapping off. So only do it the one time you need it to get it into the position that you want. Our Talon Sergeant has now cleaned and we're ready to glue him onto the slotter base. Now, when you're gluing a metal miniature into a base, you might find sometimes that the slot just moves around a little bit. So what we can do is a cool little trick to make that a little bit more secure. It's very simple. All you need to do is get hold of your clippers and the tab underneath the base. What you do is place the clippers just very gently about halfway like that, and then just very gently just twist ever so slightly like that, just to put a little kink in the slot like that. Now, this will just mean that you get a better grip on it. And all you've got to do then is put some super glue on, and we just need to put a little bit on the parts that are going to make contact. So there we go, just a bit there and a bit underneath each foot as well. And with that done, we're now ready to glue the miniature into the base. The super glue is now completely dry and our miniature is now ready to be undercoated and painted. So if you guys are thinking of adding some metal miniatures to your army, we really hope this video helps you out, and we'll see you all again soon.